One of the Philippines' UK COVID-19 variant cases is linked to the cluster of cases in the Metro Rail Transit System, or MRT. Health Undersecretary Maria Rosario Vergara says the case involves a 46-year-old woman from Pasay City who is connected to the MRT cases cluster because her child works there. The patient tested positive for the virus last January 25th and is now undergoing home quarantine. It is still unclear if other MRT cases will undergo genome sequencing to check if they are also positive for the UK variant. The Philippines has so far recorded 44 UK variant cases. Overseas, the more contagious COVID-19 variant from the UK reaches New Zealand. Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern says the two UK variant cases were part of the cluster that prompted the lockdown in Auckland. The source of the infections is still being investigated.
Now, just keep in mind, we don't necessarily have to get to the bottom of that precise issue in order for us to lift restrictions. What we'd like to do, though, is really put a ring around things, make sure that we're testing all of those places of interest, getting those results of close contacts back in, to give us a level of confidence that whatever has happened, we feel confident that we've got a bit of a ring around it.
Ardern ordered a 3-day lockdown in Auckland until Wednesday. The COVID-19 alert for the rest of the country was also raised to level 2, with all gatherings limited to 100 people. New Zealand has been widely praised for its handling of the pandemic, reporting only over 2,200 COVID-19 cases and 25 deaths in a population of 5 million. In the U.S., a new coronavirus variant discovered in California is being blamed for a surge of infections during the Christmas holidays. Here's the full story.
As U.S. coronavirus vaccination efforts ramp up, a growing number of virus variants could challenge the public health response. Researchers at Cedars-Sinai Medical Center in Los Angeles told Reuters that a new coronavirus variant found in California drove a surge in cases during the Christmas New Year holiday period. Dr. Jasmine Plummer compared the Cal-20C variant to another highly contagious mutation, first discovered in the United Kingdom.
We're learning a lot from the strains. If we look at the UK variant, we're actually learning that it's more infectious.
On Sunday, CDC Director Rochelle Walensky said there are over 1,000 cases of the British coronavirus variant known as B117 in the United States. She added that it may become the dominant strain by the end of March. The highly transmissible South African mutation was also detected in the United States at the end of January. Reuters data on Sunday showed there were more than 27 million coronavirus cases in the U.S. The nation's death toll is steadily climbing toward 500,000. Rite Aid CEO Hayward Donegan on Sunday said vaccine supply has so far been unable to meet the demand. She added that private sector pharmacies would be best equipped to help with regards to scheduling vaccinations, which is so far still in the hands of state and local jurisdictions. Late last week, U.S. President Joe Biden said the U.S. would have enough vaccine doses for 300 million people by the end of July.
The United Kingdom hits its first target of vaccinating 15 million people of its most vulnerable against COVID-19. But Prime Minister Boris Johnson admits they still have a long way to go. More in this report.
British Prime Minister Boris Johnson hailed a significant milestone on Sunday as the UK hit its initial target to deliver 15 million first doses of COVID-19 vaccinations. After becoming the first country in the world to approve a vaccine, the British government began its ambitious programme in early December with the aim to offer a shot to everyone in its top four priority groups, including all care home residents and frontline healthcare workers.
Today, we have reached a significant milestone in the United Kingdom's national vaccination programme. It has been a truly national, UK-wide effort. We've done it together. And I want to thank each and every person who has helped make it happen. You can be incredibly proud of the part you've played. And thanks also to everyone who has had a jab so far, giving protection not just to yourself, but also to your fellow citizens and to the NHS.
The vaccine programme is seen as one of the few successes in the UK government's handling of a pandemic that's left the country with one of the biggest death tolls in the world.
We've still got a long way to go, and there will undoubtedly be bumps in the road. But after all we've achieved, I know we can go forward with great confidence.
The rapid progress is fueling calls for the authorities to start relaxing tight lockdown measures in force across the UK.